Hi, everybody. Welcome to Dr. Fixmaster. I'm posting this video to address concerns about YouTube's new channel monetization rules. The new rules are that in order for them to pay their creators for advertising for the content they post, they have to have 1,000 subscribers, 4,000 hours per year of viewership. So that creates some problems. The numbers were a lot lower before. Pay for a channel is roughly $100 per 100,000 views. So it's basically two football stadiums full of viewers for $100, which is, it's a pittance, but it's still an incentive to produce quality content. My problem is that 1,000 subscribers is a huge disincentive. My channel is about information. It's not mindless entertainment like belching people or fistfight compilations or comedy TV. That's not what it is. No one subscribes to that kind of a channel. It's one-stop shopping for information. The new rules selectively punish the people who are working to put together the world's largest video library of useful information. So when people come to my page, they have something that's broken. They do a search on YouTube with their powerful search engines and they find a solution, fix what they need to fix, and then they move on. So having a minimum rule of 1,000 subscribers is a huge hit for people posting informational videos like myself. To me, that kills the essence of YouTube, which is about collaboration and sharing, the sharing of information. The new rules are heavily biased towards useless TV station type content, and they are heavily against informational content, which is more of the one-stop shopping stuff, as I mentioned. So here's the thing. What are the new rules really about? As in all other human institutions, the way that you find out what it's about is you follow the money. There's a huge swath of small contributors that are now out. What does that mean? It means Google spends less money on YouTube. That's not terribly surprising, but it is very disappointing, and it actually threatens what YouTube is. It's their decision. I think it's a dumb one. So if you have a channel of your own, you should let them know what a crock you think that that is. Now, one thing I found was that there's no avenue for feedback. So my only recourse was to use the site to post a video like this to let people know what I actually think about them. So if you have a channel, you got to fight the way that you can with a video like this, calling them out and telling them what a dumb idea it is. What does this mean for creators? It means no pay. Basically, you're getting paid before, now you're not getting paid. Now, that said, it doesn't make that much of a difference anyway, because it was a pittance before, it's a pittance now. It's just you were getting paid a pittance before and now it's nothing. So that's okay. I mean, as far as my income is concerned, my day job supports me, and my YouTube stuff is just a hobby. And it's a hobby that I plan on continuing, except for certain contingencies, and I'll get to that. so my other big problem with these rules is that it affects the content. What you have now is a bunch of people having to beg for subscribership, and that's just annoying. It's really annoying to have to be forced into a situation where you have to beg for subscribers. And it's annoying for people to have to subscribe. You know, if somebody uses my site to fix something on their car, they don't want me spamming their email accounts every time I post something else, because the information is no longer relevant. And I don't think that the people at YouTube figured that out before they pushed these rules out. So that's disappointing. you can't really apply a one-size-fits-all minimum subscribership rule. I have absolutely no I meet the viewership rules, generating enough hours of viewership every 3 months for what they require in a year. So I have no trouble getting people on my site. It's the subscribership thing. It just doesn't lend itself to that. And that's disappointing, because the power of YouTube is those search engines and people sharing information. That's what YouTube is. That's what made Napster so great back a while back, where you could look up any song, because you've got this global audience of people combining their content and you can find anything. But this is working against that. These new rules will hopefully not kill that, but we'll see. So for me, I'm going to keep running the videos unless YouTube continues to run ads on my page. If they're not going to pay me for the content, then why should I work extra to post videos that they're getting paid for? I have an ethical problem with that. And so I'm going to be watching that when the due date passes. If they run ads on my page, I'm going to have to pull the whole channel. So that's the bottom line for Dr. Fixmaster. And maybe that means that this hat will stay as clean as it is. But thank you for listening, and happy fixing.